as teaching wasn't stressful enough. Try doing it in a power cut.
I don't think the Wi-Fi is going to reach.
Sadly, in this part of the world, grid blackouts are all too common.
So we haven't had power the entire morning. We have load shedding. The generator has also broken this morning once. I'm a teacher. I'm actually supposed to be a science and math teacher, but I do spend some time with white leads every day trying to get power to everyone.
We're back in South Africa, again looking at the issue of load shedding, assessing its impact on this school, and seeing once more how Victron Energy products can intervene positively in these challenging situations. Pomario Private School sits on the edge of Citrusdal, a community in the southwest of the country, catering to learners from 3 years old up to the age of 18. There are 170 students currently, with 65 children in the preschool alone.
Our aim is to provide quality education and quality alternative in South Africa. We pride ourselves in smaller classes with internet access and projectors and all kinds of technology in each class.
As with all schools, a stable electricity supply is a basic need in order to fulfill the most fundamental tasks and activities. Unfortunately, this is not currently a given across South Africa, with many schools relying on backup power contingencies.
This happens every day. If we're lucky, it only happens once a day, depending on the stage of load shedding. So currently we have stage 6 load shedding. So that means we have 3 power outages a day, but normally only 2 of them will fall in school hours. Yes, so they can't be taught. They work from their laptop, so if they don't have electricity, then they can't work.
So you've got from a stage 1 till stage 8. We luckily never got to stage 8. We are basically at stage 6 now. Stage 8 is basically, I think you have like 2 or 3 hours power a day. So on stage 1 you will be off one time a day for 2 hours maybe, and from a stage 3 it will be 2 to 3 times a day. Stage 6 you will be 3 times a day, but in intervals of 4 hours per interval. So in a 24 hour period, half of the day you don't have power.
I think in South Africa we've learned to be adaptable, but along the way we forget how much we lose along the way. As you would have seen, we have the generator, I have it on a trailer, I have to bring it in the morning, start it up, connect the printers, the internet and everything before even the staff comes in. We have a light in the staff room that we need to connect so that we can see what we are doing. If I think of the time and energy that just goes into that, it will be wonderful not to have that in future.
Load shedding, as explored in this video, is a series of rolling power blackouts in South Africa, enforced by the government-owned national power utility Eskom, and is caused in no small part by the country's continued heavy reliance on aging coal-fired power plants.
They turn the power off so that a specific industry or specific town has power for that time period, and then they take the power away from them again and give it to somebody else. So they're basically just balancing the scales between the demand that they don't have.
In the face of such continued disruption, the school has decided to embrace renewable solar energy in order to ensure more stability for teachers and students.
The influence on our academic program is huge. The effect of load shedding and the limited power supply we currently have. So having a new system with the solar and inverter system in our school will be a game changer, because our teachers currently can't really plan because they have projectors in their classes. But if they plan to do something via slideshows or a video or whatever, they don't know if there's going to be power that they can play it. And also it gets very hot in summer here in this area, so we have air conditioners in all our classes. But then when the air conditioners can't run, then we have a situation that students find it difficult to focus. And in general, it's very difficult to run our academic program as we would like to do it.
And that's the thing with in the whole of South Africa and also for the school is we want to drive the costs down, but we still need that, let's say, luxury of lights that's on and your computer systems that's on. It's actually a necessity, but for most communities, it's actually a luxury. So as soon as we can go that way of doing renewable energy, we already know that we have enough to do the day-to-day runnings and also to give this the students a better sense of education at the end of the day.
With all that in mind, the school has begun installing a robust Victron energy system that will provide stable electricity supply at all times, which is where local installer Sonop Solar come in.
So we decided to go with the Victron product because the Victron is the superior product out of all that we've had, that we've worked with. It's just the after-sales support on the Victron is just fantastic. You don't get that on any other product. We use the Victron because it's expandable. You can build it in three phases. So the first phase is going to be the 45 kVA, which is currently installed. And then we used about 70 kilowatt hours of storage just to keep them going through the day if there is load shedding. And then we've installed about 20 kilowatts of PV new panels, and then about 20 kilowatts of PV was sponsored from an old project. Currently they have a 50 kVA and we installed a 45 kVA for them. So the next phase will be a 90 kVA. So if the system is not going to be sufficient, they might just have to put off one or two of the bigger aircons, so then the system will be sufficient for them again.
We won't have to waste hours of our day trying to get access to electricity. We'll be able to actually sit here and work and focus on learning rather than being interrupted by no Wi-Fi.
It will really be a great help, and we will be able to relax, and most importantly, we will be able to continue with what we are here for, which is a proper academic program.
As a community or a school grows, the demand gets bigger, and the system that's in it's big enough for what we have now. But as the school grows, we will most probably need to expand it.
Experts say there's no end in sight for the load shedding that plagues the South African economy. But it's hoped with a new Victron energy system installed, this school at least can wean itself fully off the unstable national grid and from relying on the generator. And in time, they hope to expand the system in order to attract more learners and achieve the target of having 300 students learning on site. On our YouTube channel, we have a number of playlists where we break down our films into categories. Check out these suggestions.